Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's use the new chemistry that we've learned on the topic of acetylides to make something. Let's say we need to make the molecule in the upper right. And we are provided with a starter material of phenylacetylene, which is shown in the upper left. How would we accomplish this transformation? Well, let's start by counting our carbons. The product has four more carbons coming off of the benzene ring than the starting material. We need to add those carbons. We also need to convert the alkyne into an alkane. That will require an addition of hydrogen. So those are our steps. One, extend the chain. We'll do that with our SN2 reaction on an acetylide. Two, we'll reduce the alkyne to the alkane. Let's do it. The SN2 reaction, SN2 alkylation, first requires that we make our acetylide. We'll do the deprotonation of our alkyne with a base, sodium amide. The N minus removes the proton. That gives us our acetylide. The end of our first steps. We'll then add our alkyl halide. Let's give that sodium plus in there too. We'll add our alkyl halide. Remember, we need four carbons. We'll add butyl bromide. It's a nice primary halide to react with our basic yet nucleophilic acetylide. That's step two. We get our substitution. Get our count right. There's our carbons. Now we just need to get rid of the alkyne and convert it to an alkane. In this case, we see a common problem in writing out reactions. We run out of space on the right. So what we'll do is we'll wrap our synthesis and start over with a new line. Start over again from the left to the right. So our reagents for this last step will be hydrogen and palladium to reduce our alkyne to the alkane. We don't need a fancy catalyst for this. And we will get our six carbon chain off the end, our alkane. Note that we started with six with the alkyne, and now we finish with six in our alkane. This isn't a difficult transformation, but it does highlight a common challenge in synthesis. For this transformation, the alkyne was vital for allowing us to put together the overall structure. The product, however, gives us no hints that we ever had an alkyne. Sometimes our products do not contain traces of important features that allow the synthesis of the product in the first place. A key skill you will acquire over time is the ability to infer the missing functional groups to work backwards in a synthetic route. This skill is difficult to obtain and requires lots of patience and practice.